never done you wrong, sir. Never, I say. Mr. Owen, you are truly the most insufferable fellow I have ever had the misfortune to count among my acquaintances. Mr. Dickens was right. Foul weather... I have told you before, sir, I had nothing to do with that anonymous article. Nothing, I say.
That is a lie, sir.
And you know it. Bah, I don't have time for this nonsense.
Nonsense? It is my name and reputation you have willfully besmirched, sir. My very name.
Bah! Drive, damn you, drive! Yeah.
That is Richard Owen. A vile, despicable wretch of a man.
Really? I could have sworn you were close friends.
Mr. Owen works at the asylum. He will know who made the syrup. Get him! Get him!
Faster, you nitwit! Faster!
On, girl. This type of vehicle to take.
I just have a few questions for you, sir.
Whatever it is Darwin wants, I will not give in.
Stop, for pity's sake, stop, or I will tell you everything I know! That's the way.
Dr. Elliotson! Dr. John Elliotson! He formulated the elixir! He's the man you want! Not me! I beg you, good sir!
On
you
go now.
This madness!
Now, was that so hard?
Today's your lucky day.
No, Sifa.
Show him how it's done.
Back on the car!
The aura of death surrounds thee both.
Get thee behind me!
Alas, these days, stupidity is all too prevalent. You know, I never asked your names when we last met.
I'm Evie Frye, and this is my brother Jacob.
Tell me, do you believe in ghosts?
Not particularly.
Yes.
I'm skeptical myself. Here we are, in the world's most advanced city. Yet its citizens are so enthralled to the supernatural, they leave themselves vulnerable to charlatans. Which is why I joined the Ghost Club. The first society in the world to look systematically at the phenomenon. Because truth, like a spirit, must be cajoled before it will reveal itself. Will you join us?
Sounds absolutely ridiculous. Why not?
It does sound intriguing.
Splendid. I have your first case. There's been some disturbing reports about a series of assaults in Lambeth. People claim they're being attacked by an age-old demon, Spring-Heeled Jack. The fiend is no doubt on the prowl as we speak. It's up to you to...
We just close.
I have you now. Claw marks on the walls.
What's going on?
have you now.
Good riddance to bad rubbish. This brute's met a nasty end.
Charge him.
Warehouse, lots of guards, mass lunatic inside. This is the bloody life.
Get him.
Thank you. 4 and 20 blackbird bait dinner pie.
I've got this.
I'm late.
You might want this.
Thank you.
You over there. Yeah. What's gotten into
might
you?
Well done.
All right then.
Standing ready if you need help.
We've
ladies
been waiting.
Gentlemen,
give us a second. Step on
that.
We have work to do. Take them. Take care of this. They're all yours.
You shouldn't be here.
And what are you going to do about it?
You seem tired, friend. Everything all right?
There's always too much work to do.
Today's Ghost Club investigation involves a carriage. It's said to be covered with gold leaf, dazzling passers-by when the sun shines. Naturally, it's rumored to be haunted.
These letters never reach their destinations. How sad. The Royal Mail coaches vanished when the post began to be transported by rail. Oh, I'd rather enjoy a sit down, but duty calls. Curious.
Help! Please, someone help me!
You don't have to worry anymore.
Oh, you saved me. That wretch would have forced me to marry him within the hour. I must return home.
Shoot now! Faster!
Saved my life. I am Elizabeth. Won't you climb down and sit beside me so that I might see your face?
Where is she?
You look as though you're just about to collapse. What on earth has happened?
Just a dream. Or so I think.
Right.
key to the...
Spate of rather intriguing thefts about town recently.
Robberies in London are hardly supernatural events.
They look like common robberies at first, but these perpetrators have all claimed to have been under the influence of some supernatural power. I'm not so foolish as to forget that criminals will spin any yarn to avoid the law. However, these thieves all proffer the same defense. They say they will be controlled by a demon.
What's that man done?
Really have to do that?
Rob the pawnbrokers down the road.
A demon made me do it. I can't remember much. Please. That's what's so queer. I've never stolen anything in my life before.
Let's pretend that I believe you. Tell me who made you do it.
All I can recall is a silver watch swinging in midair. It was held by someone or something. A dark presence whispering. I could only see its eyes. A demon.
I'll need to verify this with the shopkeeper.
Huh.
prices. I import my wares from all over the world. Maybe someone ought to notify the loony bin.
Are you well?
You'll need to.
You won't find the likes of these anywhere else in London.
What can you tell me about the robbery?
There's not much to say. Most of the items did come from the same cellar. Enzio Capelli, Sorcerer Supreme, a famous showman from Italy. Several weeks ago, he was forced to pawn his family heirlooms, debts. I have the address of the last person who redeemed something of his. A lovely pearl necklace. That helpful?
Not again! Stop her! Stop! Somebody stop that thief!
Don't you look where you're going!
Where am I? What's happening?
You took something from a pawn shop.
It's all very hazy, but I remember something silver flashing in front of my eyes. Then I heard a sort of bell. Next thing I know, I'm here with you.
My only lead is this mysterious buyer.
I need more time.
This chap might lead me to the demon. Mr. Enzio Capelli, I presume? So you're responsible for the theft of your own jewels?
You are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. And now you are so very, very tired, aren't you?
Yes, I'm very, very tired.
Now, you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
My goodness, what foul behavior.
What's going on? Where am I?
You've been arrested for theft. How very intriguing.
I can't remember a jot of it.
Let's get you out of here. I've pulled a few strings, and they won't prosecute on account of your losing your mind. Be free, little chicken.
Don't worry, dear. I won't tell anyone.
recollection of the events that landed you in a cell?
I remember what the other victims remember. A silver watch, the sound of a bell, and a sort of shadow.
A glint of silver and a tolling bell. I must say, you look very tired.
Yes. I am so very, very tired.
Now you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
Now I'm going to do a little job of work for you.
You've cost me a bit of money, mate. So I think it's only fair that you replenish my coffers with donations from the good people of London. You will steal money for me, won't you?
Yes, I will steal money for you.
From me, you dodger!
Good. Very good. Now, we can't have criminals like you roaming the streets. You will surrender to the police, won't you?
Yes. I will surrender to the police.
Oh, and when you do, you're going to do a silly little dance for them.
I say, you gave me a terrible fright. Muttering about a man named Ezio.
Ezio Capelli. Not a demon, but a hypnotist. And he's not even Italian.
I suspected hypnotism from the very start. You must find the villain.
You're going to stand watch while they ransack this house, aren't you?
Is there somewhere else in the house?
I'm going to stand watch while you ransack this house.
You're going to obey the bell.
Yes. I'm going to obey the bell.
Mr. Capella says I won't remember this when I'm finished.
You are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I am very much mistaken. Oh, wait. No, I'm not.
Italian. It was just for my act. Nobody wanted to see a British hypnotist.
Oh, shut up.
I'll give you anything you want.
I want you to shut your mouth. Do you know a doctor?
Never heard of the man.
Did you?
My body doesn't bend that way.
Time to confess and free the people under your silly spell. Well, Charlie, I suppose the Ghost Club holds some new horror for me today?
As a matter of fact, yes. Follow me.
Oh, really?
Number 50, Berkeley Square. Four stories high and branded, beware all those who enter. There have been many strange tales of this dreadful domicile. The earliest report of a haunting was said to be the specter of a small girl who was murdered by a servant. She could be seen at the attic windows, weeping and wringing her little hands in an agony of despair. I'm eager to begin.
Another legend claims the attic is haunted by the spirit of a young woman who purportedly threw herself from the top floor windows to escape her abusive uncle. Her screaming ghost has reportedly been sighted hanging from the window ledge. This residence was briefly owned by a Mr. James Jasper, a choirmaster and an opium addict. His nephew Edward was betrothed to one of Mr. Jasper's pupils, the fair and delicate Rose. However, Edward disappeared under mysterious circumstances, followed by Jasper himself. Perhaps grief sent him back to the soothing arms of his narcotic mistress.
Yeah! Yeah! Whoa!
Let's go.
Shall we? Though this house is vacant, some say it comes alive at night with screams of terror, ringing bells, and slamming shutters. Although eerie, this phenomenon is easily produced by pneumatic tubes and valves. There are claims that a young man was caged in the attic, his only connection to the rest of the world, a tiny hole in the door. A young man who was reduced to madness by this extreme isolation. The legends all seem to focus on one room in particular. Sudden draft. Nothing more. My word. Perhaps I shall wait here while you investigate the source of that laughter, which is not at all unsettling.
Why were you hanging around that house?
What's it to you?
Tell me or I'll drag it out of you.
Right away! We were there for the treasure. We found a key to the secret passage.
Secret passage?
Yeah, number 50's got a secret passage. Here, take it. Just leave me be.
I've found a...
Lucky for you, I've got it.
So this is how it works.
How disappointingly dull.
Get out of my house!
Get clear, child!
for Rosa came near to equaling mine. It should have been enough to keep my beloved nephew away. My poor Ned. Forgive.
Alas, the myth has been discredited. There was no ghost in Berkeley Square. Just a wretched soul, driven to murder and madness by guilt and intoxication. I think this has the makings of a rather fine novel. I wonder if I've got one left in me.
Having a bit of fun, is he? Smells like trouble.
Thank you.